الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد. It's imperative that we follow the companions of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم رضي الله تعالى عنهم أجمعين. ولو كره الكافرون ولو كره المشركون ولو كره أهل بدع. And here's something beneficial from our brother Abbas Abu Yahya, حفظ الله تعالى. Relating to following the companions of the Prophet ﷺ. And these are various narrations from the companions and the Salaf, Salaf al-Saleh, Ridwanullah alayhim, ajma'in, that pertains to following the companions of the Prophet ﷺ. From Hudhayfa ibn Yaman, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, who said, follow our paths. Because verily, if you follow us, then indeed you have truly advanced a lot. And if you oppose us, then indeed you have become extremely misguided. From Ja'far ibn Amr, rahimahullah ta'ala, who said, we were a group from the children of the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. We said, verily our fathers have indeed preceded us with hijrah and companionship of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So let us strive in worship in the hope that we will reach their excellence. We came across Tamim ad-Dari radiallahu ta'ala anhu as an old man who could not stand nor sit due to the length of his prayer. From Saleh ibn Kaysan rahimahullah ta'ala, who said, I met up with az-Zuhri and we would seek knowledge together. Then we said, we should write the Sunan. We should write that which came from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Then we should write that which came from his companions, as indeed it is the Sunnah. So I said, it is not the Sunnah, and we should not write it. He continued, so Zuhri wrote it, but I did not write it. So he was successful, whereas I became lost. From Muhammad ibn Sirin, rahimahullah ta'ala, who was asked about combining the Umrah into the Hajj. So he said, Umar ibn al-Khattab and Uthman ibn Affan, radiallahu ta'ala anhumah, disliked it. And if it was knowledge, then they are more knowledgeable than me. And if it was their opinion, then their opinion is better. From Sa'id ibn al-Musayyib, rahimahullah ta'ala, that he was asked about something, so he said, the companions of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam differed regarding this, and I can have no opinion to place along with theirs. From Mujahid, rahimahullah ta'ala, who said, the scholars are the companions of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. From Abdurrahman ibn Amr al-Auza'i, who said, rahimahullah ta'ala, knowledge is that which came from the companions of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and that which did not come from even one of them, then it is not knowledge. From Ibrahim al-Naqa'i, rahimahullah ta'ala, who said, if it had reached me concerning them, meaning the companions, that they did not exceed in the wudu more than a fingernail, then I would not exceed it. Radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in ala salaf as-salih, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala preserve the scholars of Islam, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us with ikhlas wal ilm. Those things which please him, subhanah. And anything that I said that was correct was from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Anything that I said that was incorrect was from myself and the shaitan. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us all with tawfiq and bless us to follow the way of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his companions. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, alaykum bi sunnati wa sunnata khulafa rashideen al-mahdiyeen. عضو عليها بالنواذج وياكم ومحدثات الأمور فإن كل بدعة ضلالة. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from every type of misguidance and every time and every way in which we may lead ourselves and lead others astray. وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد.